Makeup can do a wonderful job if it is used intelligently. There are no set rules about what to use or how to use it. Each woman is an individual and represents an individual set of problems. The important job that makeup can do is emphasize a woman's strong points and at the same time play down her weak ones.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Sometimes I think, wow, I'm 12 years old. I feel like I'm so much older than that. I feel like I've been on the earth for so long, but I'm only 12. I feel like I'm an old lady, but I'm only 12. I feel like I've been here for a long time, so I don't know why I'm still young. Some people say this thing called old soul, and it means you've been reincarnated many times. I think I was a famous singer. Like a pop star. What if I was famous? And I sang. My favorite age was when I was 7 or 8 years old, though. It was just fun. I can't explain it. Some of the stores I used to like are closed down now. Very sad. But when I'm older, I can have money in my own bedroom and I can decorate it. Nature is just boring. I don't know what to do with it. I like people. People are fun. Nature is boring. Nature doesn't do anything. Nature doesn't talk to you. With people you can play games and talk and stuff. I like to play board games with my family. Nature is also. I've heard about global warming. The world is gonna get hotter. I think. There won't be snow anymore. Animals are going to die, maybe. We learned about it in 5th grade and the whole time I was thinking about when it was all going to happen. How long is it going to take? Do you know? I don't know. It's on the TV. One time when I got my first glasses, I put them on and everything was so clear and the news was on TV and I saw a man be hit by a bomb. Then last year I remember seeing the news about the virus. Strange. I didn't think it was bad. I get my news from social media because I understand it more. And people at school were saying it was all going to be okay. Weird. Sometimes you don't think the news is real because it's scary. But I see it on my phone. I close it and watch cooking videos or play games and stuff. Literally. My favorite word is literally. My favorite planet is Neptune. It's blue and it's so cool. I hate Earth. It's the only one that has water, I think, but it's so boring. And it only has one moon. And bad things happen on Earth. On the inside, I'm more mature, I think. I feel older than I am. I'm not even at an important age, yet. People look forward to being 16. I don't care, but I do care, at the same time. What I want to go back to, is being a little younger. Before high school, it was fun, but maybe that's because I was so stupid the whole time. Being stupid is fun. No one tells you that. They want you to be smart. But it's so great not overthinking everything. It must be nice not having any thoughts in your head. I barely remember my childhood. Even though it was so recent, I have bits and pieces. I loved regular kids' things, like candy and cartoons. Whenever I saw something important on the TV, I used to tune it out. Once, I walked in on my parents watching the news and some guy was attacked by a lion. The news has so much violence, but it's also censored at the same time. They want you to know that something bad happened, but they can't show you exactly what it is. But it's helpful sometimes. When I was in the 1st grade, I saw my first ever tornado. I barely even cared. We all hid in tornado positions to be safe, but I just went to sleep on the floor. We were sent back home and my mom was watching the news for updates. So it's helpful sometimes. I'm like a lot of people my age. I learn everything online. I learned about climate change online. I try really hard not to think about it, because I don't feel like there's anything I can do about it. We learn the most basic things in school. So when we learned about climate change, we just saw footage of polar bears on melting ice caps. We were all kids. We were all about to cry. All they talk about are the ice caps, though. Not how it's going to affect us personally. So it does scare me. Everything we don't know scares us. Old people can be afraid of technology, because they don't know a lot about it. They blame our generation for technology, but they're the ones who made it. We just grew up using it. I don't blame them. They're human. They're afraid of the things they can't change. I always think about my age on my birthday. On any other day, I totally forget it. I have to tell myself, don't think about it, you can't change it. Whenever I see a sign of wrinkles, I have to stop and think, oh my god. I'm 21. I'm growing up. Then I remember I'm not a teenager anymore. It hits me sometimes. My favorite age was when I was in middle school. We felt like we were untouchable. We were the uncoolest people ever, but we thought we were so cool. And we were children that we felt like we were adults. I remember my first CD was this Britney Spears hit CD when I was 6 or something. I saw it at Walmart and her clothes in the picture. They were so scandalous. It was this feather shawl and low-rise leather pants, and her body was all greased up. I asked my mom to buy it for me. Being a real adult is like being a machine. Obviously we aren't machines. But capitalism made us into machines. Constantly trying to find a job or get money. It doesn't fucking matter, it's so mechanical. We're living beings, but we live in a mechanized world. I think about climate change every single day. There was a snowstorm in February. In Texas. That's not supposed to happen. I was aware of it when I was a kid. When we were little, it was called global warming. I remember seeing natural disasters, seeing Haiti on the news. I was so scared. I felt helpless. Then the movie, 2012, came out when I was in middle school and wasn't necessarily about climate change, but it scared the shit out of me. The thing about climate change is that we can do something. Humans accelerated all of this. What we could do is confront these corporations. Get rid of them all. Immigrants are much more mindful and wary of waste. We're always thinking about how to reuse things. My family uses plastic bags until they have holes in them. That's an immigrant thing. We pass it on to our children. How to avoid waste. White people, Americans, they don't think about that as much. Especially people who had a lot of money growing up. Why would you reuse anything if you have enough wealth to keep replacing it? That's why environmental racism exists too. Poor people, people of color, they're the ones seeing the effects of climate change more than anyone else. Do you think rich people are seeing all that? I grew up in the Texas suburbs, so there's so much unused land. There's a lot of space. People always try to distance themselves from where they grew up, but I'm glad I got to be a kid here. My mom, she told me this story about me being 4 years old in the car seat singing this Cantonese song, and I knew every single word. I don't remember it at all now. I just miss being fucking free. Being a little girl. You know. Putting band-aids on our legs and dipping our feet in the pool. That's what I miss. I was scared of 2012 and ghosts. Nothing real was scary. But I still look forward to things now. I'm going to get a farm. I'm going to get a jillion animals. I'm excited to be old and at bliss with life. Old people just don't care. When you're a child, you don't care because you don't understand. When you're old, you understand, but you still don't care. That's the best part. I find myself acting like a child sometimes, and I have to ask myself, how would an adult act in this situation? I have to exit my own body. It's so scary being a grown-up. You reach a certain point where it's not cute to be a mess anymore. You have to get your shit together. You have to have a lot figured out by now. You can't act a certain way anymore. You have to force yourself to mature. My early 20s were a whole lot of fun. It was a fun kind of stress, 'cause there was so much happening. A lot of life. I moved around a lot as a kid, so I was so awkward emotionally. I couldn't handle having to get used to things. It felt so forced and unnatural. There was this scientist, I can't remember his name, but he was interviewed at the beginning of the new millennium about what he thought 2020 was going to be like, and he was so accurate. They interviewed him again this year, except it was about his predictions for 2040, and he said that we're all probably going to get really tired of technology. A collective exhaustion with it. I think he might be right. I'm feeling it already, to be honest. I'm hoping we find a way to rewind and we stop being so conditioned to rely on it, so we'll stop being such machines all the time. We're told that we need to have a perfect routine. You wake up, you have breakfast, you go to your 9-to-5 job, you come home, you go to bed. It's conditioning, but we can't operate like that our whole lives. The same thing goes for the Earth. We're forcing it to be productive when it doesn't have to be. It's unacceptable. It makes me think about climate change. I learned about it against my will. We've reached a point where you can't not know about it. I'm so aware of it all the time. I'm gonna be honest, I think about climate change once a day. It gets so morbid at a certain point that you shut down. I spent my whole childhood thinking I'm a kid. I'm a kid. I avoided adult things at all costs. But when Obama was elected the first time, I wasn't even in the country. We all knew about it and we were so shocked and happy. It wasn't always good news, though. That tsunami in Japan in 2011, there were updates on it every hour. I was sort of obsessed with it. It felt like a morbid TV show. Nowadays, I'm so emotional about the things I see, but at that age, I was more concerned with the images. They were awful. I didn't think water could do that. Whoever thought water could hurt people? I heard your first question is asking people how old they are. Well, I'm not going to answer that. I heard you asking it and I told everyone no, 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 she better not ask me this. Next question. Let's talk about the next thing. I can't. I'm always thinking about my age, you know. But recently I haven't thought about it as much. Sometimes there's a long stretch of time where I completely forget it. Then I think to myself, how have you let all this time go and you haven't done anything important? I mean, sometimes I sit there and I think, what if I just got a whole lot of money and I could do whatever I wanted? Then I'll forget all about it, all over again. After 35, you think about it a lot. Not in a bad way, not in a good way. It's just on your mind. On some days, I think about how to freeze my face completely. How can I stop my face from aging and just keep it the way it is now? I know I should enjoy still being young. I look good for my age. But then, maybe, in a year or two, I'll change completely. But I think I'm going to have so much fun as an old woman. I think the best years of my life haven't even happened yet. My sister and I talk on the phone about our childhood and what it was like when we were little kids. It was beautiful. Beautiful. Fun. Everything simple and easy. Everything. We enjoyed the simplest things. We loved the holidays. We loved getting dressed. The same programs would be on TV every single year and we always felt like it was brand new. We would laugh just like it was the first time. That's what I mean. It was always so simple. Just so beautiful. We enjoyed everything like it was the first time. We didn't care about what we couldn't afford. I used to sit with my father and watch the news, and every single day there would be another attack on Gaza, every time we turned on the TV. Then, when I was older, we saw the Gulf War on TV as well. Oh, I was just shocked when the Americans arrived. It was so violent. I was still so young when I saw it. The Gulf War. It was about 1990. It was just unreal. Not normal. There weren't any natural disasters on TV, because there were so many real disasters. War. It wasn't until maybe 15 years ago I found out about climate change. I found out about the hole in the ozone layer first. It kept getting bigger and bigger. It was terrifying. Everyone in my town was saying it was the end of the world. You can try telling them that climate change is something humans can fix, but they won't believe it. They think the world is going to end. But I've never liked being outdoors. I'm not the kind of person. I can't even walk barefoot. I can't touch a tree with my hands without thinking about how dirty my hands are getting. The world is changing so much. How did we live without technology? I feel bad for all the kids. We used to invent our own games. We used to run everywhere. Now, some kids barely ever leave their rooms. It's mind-blowing. Did I ever tell you about my adopted professor in college? He was a very old man. Very, very old. He told us that he used to drive a convertible when he was younger. Everyone back in the day thought he was hot stuff, because he drove a fancy convertible. But it was all mechanical. He would awkwardly take the top off the car and hide it in his backyard. Nothing was sleek or advanced, not even cars. Then, decades later, he was teaching technology to college kids. Look how fast things move.
Oh, Mom and Dad.